Welcome to Leaders Connect. Leaders Connect is started with a specific objective of creating 1,000 plus leaders, where all the working professionals and business people share their real-time challenges on our website, www.themassleadership.com. We see all challenges, filter them. And every week on Wednesday, we invite top management leaders from corporate company who will be giving solutions for our real-time challenges on leadership. That's when we call it as Leaders Create More Leaders.
Leaders are finding challenges. Now, a couple of leaders from different organizations are here, in fact. And one, in fact, I'd like to introduce Mr. Rangarajan now.
There are some few questions from our leaders. The question is, when we are working in an environment, there will be challenge to meet the deadline. And also, in the same time, we should be innovative. Okay, there will be a confusion which I need to select. So we want your input, how to constantly keep encouraging in the innovation within the team and within us.
So you touched an important point. So fundamentally, deadline and innovation is not an either or question, and that needs to be very clear with the leaders. It's not an either or question. Both need to coexist and both will move forward. There are way you will reward your teams, all right? That's where that change will happen. So if you keep rewarding your teams only for meeting an objective or a target, then to you, it seems like it's a problem of exclusion, that because my team is getting rewarded on this, they are only following this. And so now how can I sort of thrive on the innovation? It doesn't have to be that way. You could always create a construct where teams are rewarded on an outcome, but teams are also rewarded on. So it's the way I think about it is teams need to be aware of why, teams need to be rewarded on what, and teams also need to be rewarded on how. The moment you start putting focus on how, I think a lot of innovative ideas will start coming up. Now, the challenge of innovation is also the fact that you need an inherent risk appetite within the team to function. Because some of those ideas will fail and you will need to, you know, sort of plan for failures. Now, as a leader, it is about the way you will create your business plan in a way where you have room for failures, you have room for learnings. But at the same time, there are certain things that are tried and tested, which you have sort of motioned in an execution where you're not missing the deadline because of the innovation. Right. And this is very important as we move forward, because there are a lot of jobs that are very purely data driven, purely execution driven. And all of them will more or less start getting integrated into the machines. Right. So you will actually see less and lesser need for human beings to do the job where you don't need innovation because machines don't tire. They are not exhausted and they can just keep doing this day in and day out, right? With much more accuracy than you and me can. And so I think for the workforce of the future, it is very important that they are nurtured in a way where they are always challenging the status quo, asking the questions, and in a process, creating the ideas which sometimes may fail and hence lead to a learning, which we can actually pass on to machines, or create breakthroughs which will give you a step jump in your outcomes rather than the incremental motions that execution will drive. So I rest my case, but that's really where Ranga, we will have to lead.
Yeah, it was able to understand the question. The key points are we need to ensure deadline and innovation should coexist. So that is what we need to do. Instead of concentrating in two different things, we have to coexist the thing. And the mainly when we reward a team, they will feel better. So for innovation, we have to keep a record. That is a thing. And instead of consider what I need to do, I have to consider how to do. Yeah, that is interesting. And plan of failure. The leader is
right. It's not, innovation is not about doing something radically radically different or something like that, right? It is just about asking. As a leader, if you only get into a habit of asking the questions of why not, what if this doesn't happen, what if this does not exist, I think this will automatically give rise to innovation, because you just need to put an additional constraint on people and the innovation will follow.